Hi friend, it's Ron from CamMastery.com, where you can go to learn how to make great videos with Camtasia. This is a free lesson Friday, which means you get a free lesson right from my Camtasia Mastery course. If you want to get the entire course, you can head over to CamMastery.com/store and pick up that course. Now, onto the video. Let's now look at the canvas area. The canvas area really has two different parts. The part that your viewers can see, and the part that is what I'll call a staging area that's outside of that visible area. And in this staging area outside, you can put things that you might want to have come into your video. So for example, you might have a logo or someone's name that you want to have slide in from the side or pop up from the bottom. So you can set those things out in that area outside of the visible area. So looking at the star, you can see all of the star, but if I put it here, now people will only be able to see half of the star. And the reason for that is half of it is inside this viewable area and the other half is outside. I could take it completely outside of the viewable area and nobody would have any idea. So that's why you can stage things outside, above, below, beside this viewable area in here in the middle. Let's now take a look at a couple of canvas options under the View menu. So I'll click on View, Canvas, and then I can see the first couple are Zoom In and Zoom Out. So I can zoom in using Control and the plus sign, zoom out using Control and the minus sign. And these are the same keyboard shortcuts you can use in your browser. I also see there's a Zoom to Fill, which will fill that area as much as it can with my video. Zoom to 100% and Detach Canvas. So let's look at these. I'll show you here if I want to zoom in. Notice right up here, it's telling me I'm at 52.5%. If I zoom in, now I'm at 60. And I can go back, Canvas, zoom in, and I'm at 75. Now I'll use Control and the plus key, and you can see 85, 100, and I can go all the way in to 300% if I need to. And then I can zoom all the way back out too. And I can go out even further, all the way down to 10%. So you can see that staging area that I called it is rather large all around that canvas. Now what I like to do, what my preference is to zoom to fit or to fill. So if I say zoom to fill, then it tries to fill this area as much as possible with my video. If I zoom back out again, if I zoom to some smaller number, the same option is here if I just choose fit. So if I zoom to fill or fit, again, that's the same thing. It just fills up that space. Now, another thing I can do to zoom in and out really easily is if I have a scroll wheel on my mouse, I can just scroll down and that zooms out and then scroll back in. So it's a lot faster rather than using Control plus or Control minus. If you have a scroll wheel on your mouse, you can just use that to scroll out and to scroll in to use that for your zoom. Now we saw that one other option was to view at 100%. And the only time I want to do that is just to make sure that everything looks crisp or clear, or perhaps if I need to get something at a very precise location, I'll zoom in to 100%. But for the most part, I like to zoom to fit. Now we saw another option here under canvas, which was to detach the canvas. So let me show you that real quick. If I detach the canvas, then you can see there's this window floating outside of where that canvas area is. Now there isn't much of a reason that you would want to use this on a single monitor. Most of the time, if you are detaching the canvas, you're taking and dragging it over to a secondary monitor. I don't have a secondary monitor hooked up to this machine right now, so I can't show you that. But again, you would just drag it off to your monitor and then you would go up to the top and make it full screen like this on your second monitor. And then on the left, you would have all of your Camtasia tools, for example. Notice when we take it to a window by itself, we still have the play button and the different buttons below. I can still use this to go to different parts of the video. But again, I don't typically use this, so instead what I would do is just reattach it. So here, if I needed to reattach it, I can see that there is this button back here to reattach. But even if I just click off of it, just click anywhere else, that canvas window goes away. Now, where is it? Well, it's hiding behind this one. Now I can just go down here and click on Camtasia and say, oh, I need to see the canvas. Oh, there it is, right? Or I can go back to the other part where it has this. So either way, you can bounce back and forth between those if you just use your taskbar there at the bottom. But here, if I want to reattach this, I can just slide it over, click Reattach Canvas, or I can go under the View menu, Canvas, and then where it did say that I could detach it, now I can attach it. And that's where I like it to be when I'm working in Camtasia, so that's where we'll keep it.